I would say, like, before we get into how to hit this shot, just when you're hitting any shot off the ground, let's say, even if it's a normal lie, I'm just going to draw, like, a line like this. Okay, and let's say that the ball is somewhere on that line. Okay, assuming, like, if we had the best players in the world come hit this shot from a flat lie, they would hit the ground if they're going in that direction, like right at the line. Okay, they hit the ball before they hit the ground. Okay, and then they'd hit the ground, and their sort of divot would be kind of in front of that line. Right. So most people have a hard time doing that from a flat lie. Like most people who don't hit it as good would tend to hit behind it more. Right. So they would hit shots that you'd call fat. Or thin, which would be like if you're chopping the ball. Which would probably call some less, you know, rude ways to say poor shots. But anyway, so they both come from the same thing. They would come from the bottom of your swing being too far behind the ball. Fat and thin shots, same thing. So it makes it even harder then if you put it on a slope, right? Because now you're kind of tilted like this and trying to hit the ground in the correct spot. So most people from here would hit even farther behind it, right? So, like, what adjustments do you think you could make so you wouldn't hit behind it?
Sure, I didn't understand. Yeah. Off a different foot.
You could. You could maybe put it, which direction do you think you'd put it?
Back.
You could. I mean, you know what? I see it different from one person to the next. That's why I think it's important to just talk about literally what happened so that you can kind of maybe experiment with different techniques that would help you. You definitely need to do something to move the bottom of your swing. So you could, it might be better if you stood over on that side, maybe. You could set up with more like pressure on your front foot, assuming you're right-handed, more pressure on your left foot like this. You're kind of leaning into the hill more, okay? And then you'd have to kind of just adjust your shoulders so that they're matching the hill. Does that make sense? One thing that you can do, and I would do this not specifically for an uphill lie, but for just any shot off the ground. It's like the easiest way that you can learn how to be a good ball striker from the ground, right? So anything other than off a tee. So if you're gonna go hit balls on the range, like once it opens back up on the grass, make like a little gate like this, okay? So put two tees like right where the ball would be. And hit shots and try to miss the two side tees and try to hit this tee. Because what I'm telling you, like most people that have trouble hitting good shots off the ground will hit way back here. But like without anything there, you wouldn't have anything to reference, so you wouldn't know that you're hitting that. I mean, you probably wouldn't know. But you could definitely tell much easier with some kind of feedback. And then the two ones on the side, would cover like one of the other parts of what you need to do to hit good shots, which is kind of have the club traveling somewhat towards where you want to go. So if you hit one of these tees on the side, I mean, some of it's sort of like common sense. Like if you hit the tee on the, if you're doing this drill and you hit this tee like five times on the right, just maybe try to swing the club more that way. It doesn't have to be like some crazy, wacky stuff, but just sort of use the feedback. If you can swing and miss the tees, and hit that one out of the ground, it should make you much better from uneven lies too.
Saying is that the way we've been taught is it's always about the swing.
It's wrong.
I know, and this seems to be taking it the other way, which is good because you get too preoccupied with the backswing and the grip, and you're not.
No question.
By the time you get to the ball, you have too much.
It takes 1 second to swing a club.
Right.
Your brain literally can't think of one conscious thought. So like the important things are, where are you hitting the ball on the club face? So like if somebody asked me what the fundamentals of hitting good shots are, I would say you have to hit it in the middle of the club. You have to hit the ground in the right spot. And then the club has to be traveling kind of towards where you want the ball to go. It doesn't have anything to do with. Just because if you watch golf at all, you'll see all kinds of different setups and swings, but they all do those three things.
I think probably the most important thing initially is to talk about like how your club is supposed to go into the sand. So if you look at this club, okay, when I set it down like this, okay, there's like some air in the bottom of the club. Okay? So when we're hitting sand shots, we want this part to hit the sand first, not this part. Like a lot of people, like if you hit sand shots and you take it, I don't want to swing and look at the flash.
It's all right.
As far as the swing, I see most people like not take a big enough swing. And then it goes like I would take, if I was gonna hit this shot, even though I can't see the flag, I would hit it like this. So it's a pretty big swing. Okay, decent amount of sand, like I'm just trying to splash the sand up. I think of it the easiest way that you can. It's like the only shot that you're gonna hit where you're not actually trying to hit the ball. Okay. So unlike that one that we hit out there with the line, on this one we'd actually want the club to enter slightly behind us because we're trying to make the sand. Make sense? So we're trying to create some speed so that the sand has enough momentum to carry the ball out. You'd have to make a faster swing because the sand, there's so much sand that it slows the club down. This one, it wouldn't slow it down at all. It might actually pick up speed and get some sand there because there's not much sand. So, when there's less sand, you'd have to get closer to the ball. I mean, we could do like 3 hours. But, so, on this one, because you have to get closer to the ball, you actually swing more. You would make a normal swing like this, you might just not have to die. So yeah, when it's hard like that, try to get closer to the ball. Maybe you don't need to swing that far. Got it? Other questions? Change clubs too. If you're in the back of that bunker, you could use something. Because if you're in there and you're trying to get a sandwich, you might not be able to get far. Just use your sandwich if you don't have to. Make sense?
Is there any time when
different ways to play this? Well, it's probably an infinite number of variations you can make, but
probably three
right. Yeah. Right.
Just throw it on.
So
when no one's looking.
In order to not fall down the hill, we're gonna have to put a lot more pressure on our left foot. Right? If I would put more pressure on my right foot, I would fall. Okay, so we want to lean into the hill. So I would kind of flex my knee a lot more, my left knee, so I can lean into the hill. Match my shoulders to the hill. If I didn't match my shoulders to the hill, I would just go like this. And my club would just stop. Okay? So if I would have a shot like this, I just set up, put more pressure on this foot, and I swing along the hill like this. I might also change club depending on how far I had to hit it, because if this is my SAM wedge and it normally has this amount of loft, and then I add it to a hill that's got like this amount of loft, it might end up pointing like straight up in the air. So sometimes you might want to use something with less loft when you're hitting an uphill shot. Does that make sense? Because the loft's changing based on the slope. So the two ways that you could play it would be, same technique that I just showed you with the setup and then swing along the hill. Or sometimes if the lie is really bad, I'd set up the same way and be like super risky and just chop at it. Does that make sense? Move over a little bit, dude. So I would just make a little tiny swing if I was doing that second one and just chop it out. So really small and super risky. Well, because like people talk about, you shouldn't be risky or something like that. From here, we need to get speed, because if we're using this technique, we're not making a big swing. So just make a little swing, and you could be totally risky, and just kind of throw the club into the hill. As long as you hit the ball first, it should come out. So what do you think we do on this one? You guys kind of tell me, based on what, well, it's almost the exact opposite.
Aim to the right, goes up.
Well, again, if you kind of go back to the first thing that we talked about, like on how you're hitting shots and where you need to hit the ground and things like that, if I would set up like normal, I would hit back there. Okay, so I need to try to match my shoulders to the slope, which is almost impossible to do unless you really add lots of flex to your left knee. Like the easiest way for me to lower the left side of my upper body would be to like add more knee flex to my left leg. So if I was going to hit this one, I would go really wide just because I'd feel more balanced that way. Like if I was like this, I'd feel like I'd fall over. So I would go really wide like this and add lots of flex to my knee. Try to get my shoulders to kind of match the hill. And then I just make a little swing and try to swing the club down the hill. Most people on this shot do
No, thank you.
Tyler with the crutches. But are you aiming just close here so it rolls in?
If I was going to hit this shot normally, I would try to land it almost like just on the green or just short so it rolls out.
And they're slow right now. They're slow.
Yeah. But again, I mean, just know that when you're on a hill, it affects the club. So if it was a flat line, it would be like this, but now I add it to a hill like this, and now it's like that. So it's lower. It's going to come out a little lower. So you'd probably want to use your highest lofted club for this shot. If the flag was pretty close to us like this, if it was farther away, then you could hit a lower shot. That makes sense. But the key is, controlling where you're hitting the ground. If you really struggle with slopes, it's because you're not hitting the ground in the right spot. So you're going to have to really feel like you're tilting along the hill and swinging down the hill. It's worth a try. Have any questions about any of the shots before you go out and play?
No, very helpful.
Yeah, well, I'll send a little recap because, and like I said, some of it's just coming out here and experimenting because you might do something totally different than Cindy does. But it has to be in the context of, it has to help you hit the ground in the right spot. Make sense? So instead of saying, I hit a bad shot because my left arm was I think any of you, if I drew a line and you made four practice swings,